Is that the maximum amount of enthusiasm that you can muster on a Saturday night? Hello. It's been 2 years. Oh my gosh. Well, snap back out of it, will ya? And welcome to another sold out night at the Velvet Note! The Velvet Note's a place where you can see and hear world class musicians in a setting that's as intimate and as comfortable as your very own living room. We give you a chance to get to know the musicians and to hear the music the way that it was meant to be heard. We're a listening room. We had our acoustics designed by a protege of the Hollywood director George Lucas, under his guidance, to be the highest quality, unenhanced sound available today. And in June, specifically on June 3rd, we turned 10 years old. So, do I have a birthday out here? I'm searching. Oh, there she is. My 57-year-old eyes can barely see that far. Raise your hand so they know who you are, honey. Happy birthday to ya. Oh, wait a minute. Hark, there's another one. Happy birthday to ya. And a third, raise your hand high so I can see you. Happy birthday to ya. Sheila's keeping track of all that because many good things will happen to you tonight. And one of them is a treat from the kitchen. So happy birthday. Yeah. So I want to introduce you, if you haven't met him, to NILS. NILS originates from Munich. He started his guitar career studying the music of Led Zeppelin, and then went on to some guys with a little bit more funk to them, like Larry Carlton, who we love here. And then he broke out with his own solo career and a hit called Pacific Coast Highway, which was a huge, huge radio success for him. And he has been touring and playing ever since in huge demand. He just got back from Germany just like a couple of days ago. And every time I talk to his management, he's here or he's there, and we're really happy to get him here. The way that we got him here was to match him with some killer cats. So I want to tell you a little bit about the guys he's going to be playing with. He has Tyrone Gregg on the keys, and he has Rodney Edge on the bass, and he has Mr. Raymond. Mr. Raymond's first time gracing the doors of the Velvet Note, so let's give him a rookie applause for Corey Raymond on drums. Be kind to him, yes. Enjoy your show. And put your hands together for NILS!
How are you guys doing tonight? So, I'm still a little bit disoriented. I just got back from Europe via Los Angeles. I was in Munich for a month, taking care of my mom. I flew back home and then the next day back out here, so I don't know what time zone I'm in, so if I don't make much sense, that's why. But hey, we're gonna have a lot of fun tonight. I have some new music for you guys. A new record is coming out next week, and actually I did bring some copies tonight already. So we're gonna get a taste of that, but we're gonna start first with a track that for my last album, I guess it's officially still the current album since the other one is coming out next week. That went all the way to number one on Billboard, a little track called Out of Sight.
Thank you.
That was my second number one hit. So called Summer Nights. And I'm especially attached to it because it proved I was the one hit wonder. This is for all your cat lovers out there. Mm-hmm. because that song, I wrote it, and I just had it where the pocket is just right. Now my buddy Marcus Johnson calls it the neck factor. You know, you don't like this. All right, it's happening. I turn around, both my cats lay up on their backs, all four paws up in the air, digging the groove. So I called it catnap.
Thank you.
to hear a red piss on cup. Coming out next week, is it?
See, I'm already advertising here on my shirt.
I brought copies of the shirt too, so don't be shy and get some after the show. I'll autograph everything. New record, it's always a scary thing for an artist. Like the last album was so successful. 4 top 10 hits on Billboard, two of which went all the way up to number one. And now the next record, you know, you want to make sure. You can't slack off. I'm making my life harder and harder because the records are getting better and better, and I can't, like, you know, the labels say, well, this record could be better than the last one. So I'm doing my best. So the first single that just went to radio, I think last week for the first time, is called 9 to 5, and we're going to play that for you right now, if that's okay.
Check it out.
up a little bit of a wonder. And I was sensitive about my shit.
That's correct.
So I'm gonna play some more tracks that you've never heard before. It's always a risk, but I think you like this one. It's called Step Into the Beat.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Give a big hand to these guys here. Tyrone on the keyboards. The Edge on the bass. And Corey on the drums. I don't know their last names, we just met. Literally 2 hours ago, right? That's what tells you these are really good musicians. Yeah. Give it up for them. You know, as an artist, I travel around, and I cannot always bring my LA band everywhere I go. So I always appreciate coming to places like Atlanta, where there's just like an abundance of really great talent. And there's some of them right here. This next track, I wrote most of the record back in Germany. I spent several months there last year. My dad passed away and went through that hard time. And it's not a sad record though, don't worry. But there's this one track that I dedicate to him. It's called Our Last Goodbye. I would like to play for you guys right now.
Thank you.
I forgot how I wanted to end this myself. These are all so new songs. It's like some, a lot of this stuff is the first time actually performing them in front of an audience. So you guys are my test bunnies, so to speak.
Thank you.
This one was called the last Our Last Goodbye.
You would be very happy.
You?
Yeah. Yeah, I felt good about the fact that I did have the chance to say the last goodbye, that we got to say each other everything that needed to be said. And I don't have it hanging over me, I'll wish I would have told him love him more or whatever. And vice versa. So that's all you can, you know, hope for in that too.
Right.
You can feel it, man.
Yeah.
You know, thank you.
Also last year, that was actually this year, I was invited to play a jazz festival in the Algarve. And just before I left, I dropped off the record. And while I'm on travel, the label called NILS, we need two more songs.
Of course.
And I thought it was done. So I wrote one, and this one is called A Night in the Algarve. Guess where I wrote that one? It goes like this. When it starts.
Thank you.
stand up. I'll take my jacket off. So you guys can check out the t-shirt. This time, I have a song I want to play for you, just a solo guitar piece. But I want to play one more song from the record first, if you don't mind. That next song, you know, in smooth jazz, that they do a lot of covers, a lot of them. You know, usually R&B artists get covered, and they, some of the stuff sounds to my liking a little bit more like karaoke music, which I don't like, but you try to be creative. The point is, there's some artists that have been overlooked. And one of the artists who's a hero to guitar players, but never got covered in smooth jazz, is Jimi Hendrix. So I figured I'll give you guys a little Hendrix, if he was playing jazz. Check it out.
Thank you.
Well, this next song is a little guitar piece, if you don't mind. I just want to play a little guitar for you guys. There was a track called The Alchemist. I think it was from my City Groove album. I'm not sure. I have about 12 albums right now. I remember when I was starting out, that the biggest thing when I first came to the States, it was in the 80s, late 80s, I wanted to have a record, something with my name on it. You know, that was like my big goal. And and now everybody's just streaming stuff. But the one thing I gotta tell you, as an artist, I always think it's very important that you guys get the whole album rather than one song. And I'll tell you why. Because, we all, when we bought albums, and I thought most of them are the same generation, remember albums, right? Yeah, we bought the album for that one song that was on the radio, was so hot, and we wore it out, and got bored of it after a while, and then we got into these other tracks on the record, and sometimes I found some of the songs being my all-time favorite tracks, and I would have never bought the record
just for that song because I never heard it and it didn't hit me. It took me a while to grow into it, you know. So it's kind of like buying a record, you're getting a little bit deeper into the artist. And that's why I always am preaching that, because in today's society, it's so easy, like just download this one song and then go on and, you know, I like this song from here. But even the whole flow of a record, there's an art to it. I labor over what songs to put in what order,
yeah.
You know? So it's a nice flow to take you guys from one place. And all this stuff gets lost if you're just downloading one song. So always get the record, at least for my albums. No, I don't. We're thinking about it, yeah. It is a tricky thing. How many can you sell to justify that extra mastering for it? It's, I'd love to do that one day just for the heck of it, you know. It's just like a nostalgic old thing. I mean, even CDs these days are like nostalgic, you know. It's like an old format. Most cars, computers don't have CD players anymore, so. I get it, but it's still, I like having a physical thing in my hand. You know, albums was great because it was big, you could actually see the thing, you know. Reading album credits and all that stuff. So I got a couple more songs for you guys here. This next one is a title track of my Alley Cat CD. Alley Cat was a pretty damn good record, I must say. Because it came out the year after my Best Of album, and I didn't have to write any songs for the Best Of because it was a Best Of record, so I had over 2 years time to write songs, and I kept writing and, you know, wrote songs for other artists, but I kept the best ones for myself, and they're all on Alley Cat. And it's almost a waste because we think we just got two singles. There's about 8 or 10 singles on this record that all could have been in radio charts. So this is the title track, Alley Cat.
Thank you.
said, you better watch out what you write, never know, you might have a hit. And then you're gonna have to play it for the rest of your life. I don't mind playing this song. It's the most played song on smooth jazz radio.
Thank you.
guys. One more time, give it up for Toro. Run the Edge on the bass. Corey on the drums. And give a big hand to the Velvet Note, Tamara, and the staff. Dev is here, make sure you take good care of him tonight, right? I love you guys, thank you. For a second, autographing CDs and take photos if you guys would love to meet you all. Also, there's some notepad going around. Put down your name, email address, and this way I can let you guys know when I'm coming back and when something new is coming out. If you want to join the mailing list and the fan club. All right, thank you guys. Love you.
Thank you. Just let go of the way you see me right now. I need. I'm gonna come up with my
How y'all doing tonight?
Good.
Want to hear some music?
Oh yeah.
I think there's a band playing down the street. I'm still a little bit jet lagged. I just got back from Europe. Wednesday, flew to LA, and then yesterday flew over here.
Whoa.
So I'm not sure what time zone I'm in. So if it don't make sense, don't mind me. But I got some music for you guys. I got some wonderful musicians here, local guys who do a great job on the music. And I got some new music for you guys and some old. But I want to start with the for my still current album. We had much success, which kind of saved my behind during the COVID time. We had four top 10 singles on Billboard, two of them which went all the way up to number one.
Yeah.
So I want to play one of the number one hits for you right now, if you don't mind. The song called Out of Sight. Thank you. from the Caught in the Groove album. Reaching back a little further, my this next song is close to my heart because it was my second number one hit, proving that I'm not a one-hit wonder. A song called Summer Nights.
Thank you.
next one is for all the cat lovers in the audience. Little track called Cat. Goes like this.
Thank you. I
You can't have fear. Now, the main reason I'm here is I have a new album. The record comes out next week. So you're out of luck. No, kidding. I did bring it. The people who came to the earlier show bought up all the t-shirts, but I got some CDs left. So the new album is coming out officially next week. We just went to radio this week with this single I want to play for you right now. This is going to be the first single of the new album. This one's called 9 to 5.
You all know that one, right?
Thank you.
Grand Five, y'all. Listen for that on the radio. Should be on your favorite station. If it's not, call him up and demand it. Is there somebody at the bar? No. Can I have another glass of wine?
Sure.
The Merlot? Thank you. Yeah, it's well said it in that, right?
Yeah.
I'm not driving. next track from the same record. Hope you guys like that one. It's called Step Into the Beat. Check it out.
Thank you.
doing during COVID, I had to learn to get out a different way. I'm one of the lucky ones, I must say. I have a studio at the house, so I kept working at home. The gigs were gone, but I had a record that was going up the charts, and so I was kind of okay. But what I had to do, not to lose my audience, I learned to stream live from home. And I'm doing this still to this day. I was supposed to do today, but you know, people understand when I'm on a gig in a different state, I cannot stream from home. But if I'm not on the road every Saturday, at 6 p.m. on the LA side, which would probably be 9 p.m. here, I guess. Check it out. I do a show every weekend, every Saturday, 9 p.m. for you guys. Wow. On Facebook Live at the NILS Guitar, N-I-L-S Guitar. Okay. If you just like the page, the kind of bing comes up when I'm going live. But it's every Saturday, unless I'm out on the road. Yeah. Oh, thank you. And I thought, you know, people told me that like a couple years ago I should do stuff like that, and it always was, stuff, new stuff to learn, and you know, I started with an iPhone, and you know, and it kind of evolved. Now I have like 3 cameras and 2 computers, and running videos along with my show, and you know, getting more and more elaborate. But it's really cool because it really connected me to the fans, and it's not that long of a pause in between. You know, there was just this dead spot where there was no music. And I so much enjoyed it that I keep going it up. So check it out when you can. If I'm not on the road, I'm Facebook Live on a Saturday. And I'm playing songs like this next one. Also from the new album. This record I wrote for the most part in Germany. I went back to take care of my parents. My dad passed away last year. And my mom needs a 24-hour caregiver, and I'm an only child, so there was no other family. I had to be there. And fortunately, they have a nice enough place that I can put a studio in the basement and keep working while I'm over there. And I wrote this record. And one of the songs I wrote dedicated to my dad is called Our Last Goodbye, and I want to play it for you right now.
Thank you.
Songs. I was gonna say, okay, they're paying for it, so let's do it. I wrote this one in Portugal, in the Algarve, and I call it A Night in the Algarve. Check it out.
Thank you.
blinking light down there, which means my wireless is probably out of battery. That can happen. I just don't want it to happen in the middle of a song, so I'm putting, switching old school cable. I got one more song from the new album.
If that's okay with you.
I always keep thinking about, I write a lot of songs, so once in a while I do a cover. I only do a cover when I can give it a unique spin. I don't like doing these karaoke tracks and just put a sax or guitar on top of it, you know, instead of the voice. It needs to be unique. Otherwise, what are we, you know, what are we creating here? So there, I was looking at artists, because there's a lot of R&B artists that got covered in smooth jazz. But for guitar players, some of the idols totally got overlooked. So I figured I'd do a cover of Jimi Hendrix.
Thank you.
do I want to play next?
We have a
picture of Hendrix. Since we're talking about guitar players, mess these guys up now. I'm going to switch the set around. Another song that I need to educate people, because some people think it's a sax player song, it's a guitar song, written by a guitar player for guitar players. Even though Gato Barbieri did a great job on it, but it's still a guitar song. It goes like this.
Thank you.
Album, and there's so many great songs, it was a waste. I should have saved the songs and put them up on, like, spread them up on 3-4 records. So if you have a chance, you can go to my website, nilsmusic.com. You can listen to pretty much all my music in the music store, like old school, you know, like listen to the whole song rather than 10 seconds. And check it out. There's so many great songs on that one. And so I just want to play the title track for you guys. This is Alley Cat.
Thank you.
So where's the party at?
Right.
All right. All right. So this next song, you gotta party with me. A friend of mine told me, be careful what you write. You might have a hit. But you're gonna have to play that song for the rest of your life. Bush Lee don't mind playing this one.
Okay. Go with it.
It's the most played song on Sportsnet radio ever. Chairs and it's party go.
everybody. Tyrone on the keyboards. Lenny Edge on the bass. And Corey on the drums. Thank you very much. If you don't do us already, follow me on Facebook or Instagram and YouTube channel. Everything is Nils Guitar. And join the fan club. I will let you know when I'm back in the area, okay? I love you guys. Thank you. Good night.
Thank you.
I love you guys.
Be up there next to the door if you guys want to take photos or autographs, some CDs and stuff like that.